Hello friends, today we are going to explore a new realm in calculating or computing DFT. It is always cumbersome to calculate the Fourier transform. For example, if I take a sequence x of n, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, where n is equal to 4, then my x of k, according to the definition, is having 0 to 3 x of n w n raised to n k. If suppose we open up the bracket where my w n raised to 1 is nothing but e raised to minus j 2 pi by n. Now suppose we open up these brackets, the summation, then I'm going to get x of k as equal to x of 0 w 4 raised to 0 plus x of 1 w 4 raised to n is 1 but k is unknown plus x of 2 w 4 raised to, now n is 2, k is still unknown, plus x of 3 w 4 raised to n is 3 and k is still unknown. So this is what the sequence is all about, where each w 4 raised to k is a complex entity. Now this sequence I have to solve so that you can see that there's a 1, 2, 3, 4 multiplications. And this is going to repeat for 3 more times, because here I will calculate x of 0 for k is equal to 0, then I will put k is equal to 1, then k is equal to 2, and finally k is equal to 3. So this 4 multiplications, which are complex multiplications, are repeated 4 times. So I have total complex multiplication, if I say complex multiplications, then it is nothing but 4 into 4, 4 likewise and 4 times. Okay, so 4 into 4, which is nothing but 16 complex multiplication. If you say about addition of the numbers, then I have 3 additions over here. And 3 additions are going to repeat for 4 number of times. So I have complex addition, which is nothing but 3 into 4, which is nothing but 12. Right. So suppose this was only for 4-point DFT. If suppose I take an image, and that image is having suppose 256 total points, then the same sequence is now 256 of size. My capital N value is 256. So if suppose I extend this idea and generalize it, then now the complex multiplications will be, so my complex multiplications for a 256 points will be 256 into 256, which is of course a very huge number. So I'm going to compute my DFT for 256 into 256 times, and it's a complex number system, so it is again going to be very cumbersome. Now as the n will start increasing, the complex multiplication will become more and more complex, and DFT will take a huge time to give us the result. Even if we write an algorithm in a computer, the sequential solution of this form will require huge amount of time with increasing n. N will be very much handy if I take a 4 point or a 5 point or up to 10 point sequences. But as the n increases, even the computer algorithm will take a huge amount of time to produce the output. So a very brilliant algorithm was devised by two professors whose name was Professor Cooley and Professor Tukey. These two professors have devised a mechanism to calculate the DFT in a faster way. And that, because this algorithm actually helps us in fast computation of Fourier transform, they are called as Fast Fourier Transforms. So Fast Fourier Transform is just a technique to solve DFT in a faster manner. So we need a brilliant algorithm to actually do this job. Now what the brilliancy they have used is, because this problem is huge and we have to compute a huge data sequences, Professor Cooley and Tukey defined or decided to apply the very old technique which Britishers normally use, is divide and rule the problem. So they actually divided the sequence and computed the DFT on the smaller DFTs. So the problem was, I was having a big DFT which we called as an N point DFT. This N point DFT was divided into smaller DFTs, let us say N by 2 point DFT and N by 2 point DFT. This N by 2 DFT is further divided into smaller subsection, and let us say N by 4 DFT, N by 4 point DFT, and this also N by 4 point DFT, and N by 4 point DFT, and so on and so forth. So we have divided the given problem into smaller subsections, and now we will be computing or working with smaller subsections individually and then combining the result. This algorithm actually gave the result much more faster way, because at a time a system is operated into half the points and not the complete endpoint. This requires that the endpoint DFT should be divisible. That means I should be able to divide the endpoint into two halves. It is only possible if my n is multiple integer of 2. That means if I have sequence as 4, 8, 16, then 32, then 64, 128, and so on so forth, then only this division is possible. Because a 4 point DFT can be further split as a 2 point DFT. An 8 point DFT can be split into 2 4 point DFT first, and then each 4 point can be split as a 2 point DFT. Similar way, 16 point DFT can be further first split into 2 8 point DFTs and then forwarding till 2 point DFT. So we require that my n should be such that the final n should be such that it should be some factor of 2. That means it should be something 2 raised to x only. Well, 2 is called as the base or the radix. Okay, so my n should be such that it should always be 2 raised to some factor x, or we say that 2 raised to radical value r. So where 2 is called as the base or radix. Now this we have seen for, if I wanted to divide this DFT into two equal halves. But it is also possible to divide the sequence into three equal halves. That time the base will not be 2 but 3. It is also possible to divide the same sequence into 4 equal parts. That time the base will be 4 and so on. But it is not useful or worthy to calculate with base 4, because with base 4 the minimum base that can be achieved is 2. So all prime numbers you can take as the bases, like 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, such numbers can be the base of a DFT. And then you can break up a given sequence into that many number of subsamples or sub DFTs. So this was a basic algorithm developed by Professor Kule and 2K. With base 2 or radix 2, we basically have two set of divisions. One division we called as DIT, and the second division we called as DIF, where DIT stands for decimation in time, and DIF stands for decimation in frequency. Okay, if I'm dividing x of n, then it becomes decimation in time. If I'm dividing x of k, then it becomes decimation in frequency. This is possible with radix 2. That means the base will always be 2, and the number of sequence that I will get will always be 2, 4, 8, 32, 64, 256 and so on. So in that we will have two basic algorithms, one we called as DIT FFT and one we called as DIF FFT. Thank you.